Thank you, Norman Solomon. President Trump, just like President Obama before him, seems intent on getting the United States involved in really what is an unwinnable civil war in Syria. Launching 59 cruise missiles, for example, against rundown Syrian air bases in the middle of the night is easy enough to do, but there are consequences to these actions. And Republican and conservative celebration at this use of force notwithstanding, Trump has put Syria's Christians and those Christians in neighboring countries in jeopardy, just as President Obama and President George W. Bush did in Iraq. Neoconservative and neoliberal ideologies took root in Washington many years ago. Both parties tried to out-hawk each other on military and foreign policy to prove who is tougher, who is stronger, who's quicker to use military force. Even in countries where the U.S. has no obvious national or vital interests, there never seems to be any discussion about whether this military intervention is even legal, let alone whether it's moral or ethical. And there's certainly never any talk in Congress for authorization, despite the fact that the White House not requesting authorization is almost always a violation of the War Powers Act. Republicans' knee-jerk support for military intervention in the Middle East, whether it's in Syria, Iraq, or elsewhere in the region, ought to be anathema to any politician of either party who considers himself or herself to be a Christian. It is these military interventions that are having the effect of dooming the small Christian communities left in places like Iraq and Syria. The problem for U.S. politicians who fancy themselves as Christians, though, is that Bashar al-Assad is literally the only person standing between Syrian Christians and their annihilation. It is Assad, like his father Hafez, whether you like their politics or not, who have protected Syria's Christians for generations. Syrian Christians make up 12% of the population, according to the CIA's World Factbook. But nearly a third of the country's 600,000 believers have left Syria since the start of the civil war in 2011, pushed out by terrorist groups like ISIS and the Al-Nusra Front. And that's according to the New York Times. Before the civil war started, Christians participated in all elements, all aspects of Syrian society, including as members of parliament, as members of the cabinet, the diplomatic corps, and the business community. They maintained their own court system. They're free to practice their faith openly in churches and cathedrals all around the country. And even the Syrian military is fully integrated rather than having separate Christian units. Similarly, in Iraq, under Saddam Hussein, and Saddam Hussein was a bad man, but even under Saddam Hussein, Christians served in the parliament and the cabinet. They practiced their faith freely and openly, and they were successful in business. Thanks to George W. Bush's invasion of Iraq and the subsequent civil war there, almost the entire Iraqi Christian community has left for Jordan, the UK, and the United States. The same thing is now happening in Syria. There is a solution to all of this, but it's not sexy or quick or easy. It's something that many of us have heard about but haven't actually seen. It's called diplomacy. Whether Trump likes Assad's politics or not, the only way to save that country from becoming a failed state or an ISIS state is to sit at the table with all of the stakeholders, including the Syrians, the Russians, and whether we like it or not, the Iranians. We're going to have to accept the fact that Assad is not going anywhere, nor should he. Whether we like it or not, his is the internationally recognized government of Syria. And that is no matter what Trump and Obama have said. We should respect that, and we should sit across the table from Bashar al-Assad. Thank you very much.